Hello there and welcome to the Business Roundup for this week. My name is Viola Sasia, and just as we do every week, we bring you the latest developments from the world of business. And we have Paul on set today talking to us and helping us analyze some of the events that took place this week. So we are starting off with the Naluba Letsira power stations that were handed over back to government by Eskom, a South African company. So Paul, thank you so much for joining us. The 380 megawatt power dam was handed over back to government. And so we would love for you to tell us the details of this and what else is entailed within this transfer.
Eskom, a South African power generating company, took over Naluba Letsira to manage around 2002. They had like a 20-year deal to do this, and this has come to an end. It comes to an end actually today, March 31st. So starting April 1st, Uganda Electricity Generation Company Limited takes over. It generally doesn't change anything. It changes, okay, what it changes is government for a long time has been trying to push the power tariff down. So government is hoping that by taking it over themselves, they can cut out some costs that, for example, management fees that were going to Eskom and probably help to lower the tariff of power from the dam.
All right, so talk to us about the difference it is going to make now that we have this shifted from the private sector back to the government. What difference does this make, especially with the management changed?
So in the 1990s, there was a great move to liberalize the economy. That's allow the private sector to dominate the economy and to privatize government companies. So at the time, there was a company called Uganda Electricity Board. Uganda Electricity Board was broken up into three companies, which is Uganda Electricity Generation Company, Uganda Electricity Transmission Company, Uganda Electricity Distribution Company. So these three companies, and also a regulatory body, Electricity Regulatory Authority, was created to oversee the sector. So so all our assets which were used for generation, that at that time we only had Naluba Letsira, they were handed over to Eskom. The idea was that a private operator can be more efficient and can attract more investment into the sector, you know, to repair the dams or to expand them and that kind of business. So that's the genesis of how now Eskom comes into play, that Eskom can be more efficient in running these assets than government.
All right, so Paul, the Pearl of Africa Tourism Expo 2023 took place this week between the 26th to 29th of March as we are closing the month. So talk to us about the developments from the tourism sector and what us as Ugandans can look out for as we head into a new month and into a different quarter for the financial year that we are currently in.
No. First of all, the logic of tourism, of promoting tourism, is kind of simple. Essentially, tourism is almost considered an export of a service. What that means is that people with money outside your country and outside your economy bring money into your economy. So that's why tourism is so attractive. For a country like Uganda, where we have a lot of natural endowments, which are very largely unexploited, It's kind of a low-hanging fruit in terms of attracting revenues into the country. The people in the tourist sector, people like Amos Wekesa, say that a tourist spends at least $100 a day in this country. So the more tourists you can get, and that's an average, there's some who spend so much more, the better for the economy. And it just takes a bit of organization and understanding what the tourists want to make it happen in Uganda.
And also this week we had legislators, a section of them, arguing that commercializing of the pensions fund, the NSSF, in Uganda is going to be dangerous. And this had to do with the minister, Ruli Mukasa, coming forward and saying that some of his views were to allow some board members be able to borrow the money and return at their convenience, of course, under guidance. But so MPs think that this is going to be a preparation or a recipe for disaster. What do you think about this?
Yeah, so the minister is talking about a new pension fund they want to set up for the public service. Mm-hmm. Currently, what happens, the public service, government just, they don't contribute anything. And when they retire, government pays them a pension. A pension is a lifetime payment, or you know, they'll be paid monthly. So government is struggling to meet pension obligations, and they're thinking they should shift them to what they call a contributory fund, like NSSF. So this law is to create a separate pension fund specifically for the public servants. Now, first of all, my thoughts is that it's a waste of time and of money. You're duplicating. Why not create, adjust the NSSF law, and these guys save with NSSF? I know, I suspect what's happening is the government doesn't want to, because when you save with NSSF, you as a worker pays in 5% of your salary, and the employer pays 10%. Government, with its bad payment habit, doesn't want to be obligated and, you know, put under pressure to pay this 10%, so they created another pension sector. But they're wasting time and they're wasting money. They just need to adjust the law, and they pay into NSSF, but that's their business. So the MPs were, I think there was a clause in that law which said that in that fund, the board members would be able to borrow from the fund, and it doesn't happen at NSSF. And I agree with the MPs, it's a bad idea.
All right, so Paul, we thank you very much for making time to be a part of this interview, and we hope to meet you again next week for the latest from the world of business. And thank you so much, dear viewer, for making time to watch the latest events happening in the world of business. Stay tuned to the news every Friday to be able to catch the latest. I am Viola Xasia. We'll see you.